me go to you, Dr. Jayaprakash Mulyal, because India's coronavirus cases have crossed the 8 million mark. We are the world's second worst country now. But the number of new cases per day are around less than 50,000, as against the peak of about 83,000-90,000 in the month of September per day. Can we say the worst is over because the number of new infections are dropping, Dr. Mulyal?
Well, that expression, the worst is over, I will agree with. But remember, these numbers primarily reflect what is happening in our urban areas. So the situation is very, very promising.
You know, it's interesting you're saying that the worst is over and the situation is very promising. What do you mean? Because as I said, people are still worried about the fact that, let's say, in a city like Delhi, we are witnessing a sudden spike in COVID cases, and this has led to worries there could be a second wave, Dr. Mulyal.
Well, I don't know what the waves mean. We have ups and downs in cases being reported, and there are reasons for it. Mm-hmm. Our society is a very, very multifaceted society, shall I say. Mm-hmm. Some live in a network where they are more vulnerable to infection. Mm-hmm. Other networks are less vulnerable. So these kind of a situation produces uneven incidence over time. Mm-hmm. So that is exactly what is we are seeing. Mm-hmm. If you look at Tamil Nadu, it has been steadily coming down. Mm-hmm. And certain parts, it is doing that. These ups and downs are only natural. Mm-hmm. Please remember, the number of cases is only a fraction of the total infection that is going on. To know the true infection, you have to multiply the number of cases by a fraction, a factor of 25 or 30. So I suggest that you call it ripples rather than waves.
You know, you're making a very important point. Just let me push you on that. You are telling me today, the country's top epidemiologist is telling me actual number of people infected with coronavirus in India is 20 to 25 times more than the reported cases. 8 million reported. You're telling me 20 times more, 160 million Indians at the moment are affected?
Absolutely. How do I know this? Mm-hmm. It's from the serological studies we have been doing. And that shows the true magnitude of infection.
You know, I'm before I come back to Dr. Guleria, let me push the epidemiologist. You are telling me, therefore, that with 160 million people affected, 20 to 25 times more than those who have reported corona, does that mean we are reaching what we have spoken about in the past, Dr. Mulyal? The possibility of herd immunity slowly settling in, that we could have enough number of Indians now who already are immune to coronavirus?
I'm happy you remembered that. Yes.
Yes, so you are telling me what you told me a few months ago. We could be on our verge of reaching herd immunity. Are we on our way towards it? Is that what you're saying?
Rajdeep, this particular country is a very complex country. And there are, if you take section by section, area by area, there are certain areas which have already reached the herd immunity level. In other words, the new cases have fallen to single digits or less. There are other areas newly entering into the new infection rate. So it's a complex thing. And then you finally look at one graph, it is not clear, but predominantly, majority of the big cities have come up to high levels of immunity. So we are very fast approaching what we can recognize as a herd immunity, where the disease transmission comes down to so low level, it'll hardly be discernible. It'll cease to be a public health issue.